we are gathered here today as witnesses of the beautiful marriage of John Keola Kainalu Iaela and Ruth Hiroko Dodson Pukahi. This is a wonderful occasion. This is very, very special. Just for a second, I want you to look at everybody who's here for you. I want them to more importantly see your smiles as you... You know, we've been taught our whole lives that marriage between a man and a woman is ordained of God. That essentially the family, and that's you guys, that you guys are central to Heavenly Father's plan of happiness. Now we know that a husband and wife have a solemn responsibility to love and care for each other, and that together as parents to love and care for their children. Together they have a sacred obligation, a sacred covenant to do these things. And we know that happiness is most likely to be achieved when founded on the principles of Jesus Christ, the ones he taught. And so that means faith, prayer, repentance, forgiveness, love, compassion, respect, wholesome recreational activities. You know, and all things worth having require work. And this is no different. And so let me just say a few words of advice and then let's proceed with the ceremony. But really, anything I say, if it's like my own wedding, you're gonna forget anyway. So the most important thing, and I remember mentioning this on a previous occasion, is the best marriage advice that you will ever get has been lived in the lives of these people around you. And so remember that. Remember to have unconditional love for one another. This love should grow and develop throughout your marriage. Keola, cherish Ruth. Cherish her and let her know you love her in small ways and big ways. Ruth, respect and admire Keola. Let him know that he is your champion and that he is there. There should be a loyalty toward one another. The prophets and apostles have said, not just a loyalty, but they've said that you need to be fiercely loyal to one another. So be kind to one another. Be considerate of each other's feelings. Be willing to talk to each other. Be willing to compromise with each other. Be mature enough to recognize that there are other opinions in this world and that they are good as well. Don't try to change each other into another version of you. And so when the phone rings, Keola, and you're at work and you see Ruth on the other line, what should you do?
Pick up.
Pick it up. Done. You've decided and committed today that that's what you're doing.
Pick up. She's my boss.
Ruth, when there are times when it's really hard, just remember, you didn't marry a jerk. Assume the positive intent. If it looks like you maybe did, just remember there probably is something else going on, and that just be willing to listen and to find out. Keola, don't be a jerk. You know, I promise you that if you do this, but if you really rely on each other, that your love, the tenderness, will just grow over time and blossom into crescendo. Love is a verb. Love is what we give. It is not dependent on how we feel, if we're comfortable, if we're stressed. It's essentially, you didn't get married for you. You didn't get married for you. You didn't get married for you. You got married because this is the person you want to love for the rest of your life. You got married for the happiness of the other person. And so choose to love each other, even when it's hard to like each other. Because at the end of the day, some think that love and life is glamorous, and it has elements of that, but it's the everyday choosing to love and be loyal and to live with people that may not be perfect. I promise you that as you share the good times, the hard times, as you work together, as you pray together, as you communicate together, as you spend time with this whole family together, that's when God's going to bless your union and pour out peace upon your family. You win together, only together. And so, now is the point where you take each other by the right hand. So take each other by the right hand and stare into each other's eyes and get lost. Don't worry that there are dozens of people looking at you. And I'm going to talk to you first. John, Keola, Kainalu, Iaelu, Iaela, do you take Ruth, Hiroko, Dotson, Pupahi as your lawfully wedded wife? And do you, of your own free will and choice, covenant as her companion and lawfully wedded husband that you will cleave unto her and none else, and that you will obey and observe all the laws, covenants, obligations pertaining to this holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish her as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do. I will.
Ruth, Hiroko, Dotson, Pukahi, do you take John, Keola, Kainalu, Iaela, as your lawfully wedded husband? And do you, of your own free will and choice, covenant as his companion and lawfully wedded wife, that you will cleave unto him and none else, and that you will observe all the laws, covenants, obligations pertaining to this holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, cherish him as long as you both shall live?
Yeah. Yes.
Now is the time to exchange the ring. Now, you know that as you're exchanging these rings, these rings represent eternity, because they go on forever. But they also represent kind of the ups and downs of life. That there's sometimes it's up and sometimes it's down, and that's okay. More importantly, though, these rings, they represent these people. This is your wedding ring. These are the people who are cheering you on, who are supporting you, who are, maybe it's not rational, but they are optimistic about your future and about who you are together. We represent, all of us here, represent that wedding ring, and that you guys can do this. I've asked them to give a brief remark, both of them. They didn't want to, but I asked them to share the moment that they chose, that they thought to themselves, I want to be married to this person for the rest of my life. When did they have that moment? And Because he's a gentleman, we'll let Keola go first. And real loud, real loud.
When she burped. I knew it was meant to be. No, I came from a really big family. I mean, height and weight. So they were supported by both elements. But the one thing I felt was love from my family, especially from my grandparents. And thank you. So when she held me, it's that feeling, that energy that was transferred from her to me, which I wanted more. And she was probably the only person that I've ever been with that I could actually talk to, you know, and she talks quite a bit, so I learned a lot really fast, and I think we spent a lot of time in the beginning trying to scare each other away, but it just worked out. And I'm not looking in her eyes because I felt her, the pain. I mean, we're supposed to be talking about great things, but I felt the pain that she had to endure through. And nobody deserves to go through stuff like that. And we all deserve to be loved. I felt like my time was now. So when I met her and she held me and I held her back, she wanted to leave. She wanted to run away. I believe she wanted to run away and just go right back to the same problems that she was probably going through. But I held her and I just didn't want to let her go. And ever since that moment, that's when I knew that she would be my wife. Having my mom here and my daughter here, that's another, for me, it's a huge blessing. So I'm grateful for everybody that came, and I'm grateful for her because she gives me a lot of peace. I was all over the place, and I'm glad that she's able to put me together and help me stay together. So I love her. I love you a lot. So, your turn.
Thank you. Ruth?
The first time I met Keola, we agreed we're going to meet and shake hands. He gave me a hug. Instead. And I felt like electricity is weird. And he's right, I did want to run. I was scared. But he looked at me different. He looked at me with love, not through me, not as an object, but as a person. And then when I saw him with my children, and how he loved them like his own, and how he talked about his daughter, Kamalani, and the things he did with his daughter, and he did the same with my own. And then to see my children respond with that love. I couldn't deny he was a perfect fit. We fool people all the time. That we were just always meant to be. So I couldn't run.
She's not a runner, by the way.
I'm too slow. And I love Keola. Love you very much.
I know.
Brothers and sisters, I want you to look each other in the eye. Make it your marvelous passion. your lifelong mission to bring out the best in one another and to make them sing with their own voice. James Thurber, the English author, defined love in the best way I've ever seen. He said, love is what you go through together. And so by virtue and legal authority vested in me as Bishop of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints and from the state of Hawaii, I pronounce you, John Keola Kainalu Iaela, and Ruth Hiroko Dotson Pukahi, husband and wife, legally and lawfully wedded for the period of your mortal lives. May God bless your union with joy and a long life of happiness together, and may He enable you to keep these sacred covenants you've made. These blessings I invoke upon you in the sacred name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You may now kiss each other as husband and wife. Please, come shake their hand. Give them a big hug.